The scoreboard is supposed to compel behavior. It's supposed to compel change and activity. That's what scoreboards are supposed to do. Now, we need to do scoreboards at work much more like we do them in athletic contests. That's the goal of this discipline, is to create scoreboards at work like we have them in athletic contests. I'm sitting with a bunch of NFL football players or team owners and coaches, and I say, hey, fellas, we got to do scoreboards like they do them at work. What would they look like? Who would get to see the scoreboard if we did it at football games like we do it at work? The bosses would get to see them. The owners would get to see them. The coaches would get to see them, right? So you have the coaches standing on the sideline. They've got their handheld scoreboards, right? And they're looking at them. And the player comes, hey, coach, what's the score? What does the coach say? Yeah, well, hey, look, buddy, you just go play the game, and I'll let you know on a need-to-know basis when I find out, right? And when would the coach find out if we did it in a football game like we do it at work? It'd be the end of the game, right? You know, the end of the quarter. Well, it really wouldn't be at the end of the quarter. It'd be 7 minutes into the next quarter because accountants messing with the numbers, right? Would you ever do that to athletes in a football game? You wouldn't. It doesn't help them perform. And that's what happens at work. If people don't let us know what the score is, if we can't see the score right now, then we can't connect our behavior and our activity to results. And that's what the scoreboard's supposed to do. So if we see we're losing, we see we're behind, we need to change our behavior. If we see that we're ahead, that we're running good, the score's in green, then we need to keep doing what we know now works. That's what we're trying to do in Discipline 3, is keep that scoreboard that's compelling. We're going to do it like we do it in a football game. We go outside on a hot, sunny day like today, and you put your hand out in the sun, and it feels warm on your hand, right? Not that big of a deal. But if you take that same 4-inch patch of sunlight and focus it with a magnifying glass, how does that feel on your hand? Same energy, isn't it? It's the exact same amount of light energy, but all of a sudden you can do so. You can blow up ants. I mean, I've heard you can do that. I don't know firsthand. But what we are doing with the four disciplines of execution is we are creating urgency by process, so that you will spend some of your time every single week working on the stuff that matters the most, even though at this point in the game, it is not inherently urgent. We got tired of begging people to get into quadrant two. We don't do that very well. So we just said, all right, let's quit playing the game. Let's create urgency by process so that people will respond. What we're doing now with the four disciplines, we're saying it's not enough to just be good. We got to do things to help us become great. And so we've got to eliminate all the stuff down here that's low leverage, all the stuff that doesn't matter, all the waste of time, all the stuff that's just urgent but doesn't matter. We got to keep doing our job. We got to produce. We got to hit our numbers now. We got to maintain standards. We've got to do our day-to-day operations, and we got to get more efficient at it, and we got to delegate it so that as we're developing people to do more and more of this work, we can spend more time maximizing on the things that take us to the next level. You will never achieve a vision at a personal level or a professional level or an organizational level if you do not spend time working on it. You can't just write it on a card. You can't just put it on a flip chart. You can't just put it in a wallet thing or on the wall behind the receptionist desk. Visions happen, both personal and organizational, because behavior changes. And the time to do those behaviors has to come from somewhere. And what we hope is that it comes from eliminating the wasted time, getting much better at doing the things that we have to do so that we have some time to take ourselves to the next level.